Hi, welcome in another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to show you how to use Azure Functions from a Logic app. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez sur le lien en haut à droite. Hello again. Let me introduce myself. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based at Montreal. What I want to do today is use this JSON file that I use in my reading notes that I publish every Monday and extract the tags and only get single instance of each of one. For example, in those notes, I have the cloud and the Azure that came in every one of them. I want to keep only the unique tag. I will do that leveraging Logic App and Azure Functions. Let's do it. I'm in the portal in the Logic App we created in the last episode. If you missed that episode, the link will be in the description of this video. So now, what I need to do is clean up a little bit so I can start from fresh. So, I still need to read the file, I'll still need to parse the JSON file. The variable, I don't need a counter anymore, but I need a variable that holds all my unique tags. So let's call it unique tags. And let's change it for a string, and it will be empty at the beginning. Now in the loop, I don't need anymore the create file. And I don't need to increment my variable, so we'll delete that too. Perfect. Let's save that. Now, what I need to do is create a function. Let's go in another tab. We'll maximize this. Okay, let's create an HTTP trigger, and I will use C# since it's the language I'm comfortable with. We'll call it keep unique tag since it's what it does. To speed up the process, I already have the code, so I will just copy paste it so I can show you. Since I will be manipulating some JSON, I need this library. And now, what I'm expecting to receive is a node that will have the node with one node and unique tags as an element where I will have the list that I need to grow up. So I will read the content and create a new collection tags. Then I will take my content and make it the JSON object. Before creating my tags collection, I just need to check if it's empty. Then I split it by dot and build my collections, or otherwise I just create a new one. Then I will go read the data node tags, so here node and tags, and I receive this. It's a string with dots. So I split it by dot, and now I have an array, and I will loop through them to extract any tag that it's not already contained. Let's have a try. See, it's working perfectly. Every time I have a new tag, since now the unique tag was empty, it found 7 of them. So, bunch of details that was creating. Perfect. Now let's go back to our Logic App. So, in the for each, we'll need to call Azure Functions. To do it, we just need to add a new step and click on the Azure Functions. Then we'll pick our function app, Cloud in 5 Minutes in my case, and we'll select the functions we need. Keep unique tags. Perfect. Remember, I told you I was expecting a specific format, so let's specify this body. So we'll use this, remove everything. Yep. Voila. And current item is going here. And in my unique tag, I want to set my variable. Perfect. Now, every time the function will be called and return unique tag. Perfect. I need to take this answer and set it as a JSON object. To do it, you guess it, I will use again JSON parse. And I will use the answer I receive from my test to generate. So my content is the output of my functions and the schema. Remember, we can use this link here to generate from a JSON file. And now we have our schema. So now what we need is to set our functions with this result. So set variable. So I will pick my variable unique tags, and then for the content I will use the second parse JSON. I could have renamed it, by the way, it will make more sense, and use the tag. Perfect. Now my variable is set. Okay, so I think the only thing that left now is to save that file. So out of the for each, because we want to create only one, let's create another OneDrive. So we'll create that and I'll get back to you after. And voila! For the content of my file, I will use the variable unique tags. At the end of the loop, it should contain every instances, one instances of every tag. So voila, save. Now we're ready to test it. So run, let's bring that folder, voila. Then I copy paste my JSON file and we wait. Oh, that was quick. So we see it, everything is spent 5 turn. And if I open it in code, we can see that I have one instances of every tags that was available. Voila! In a few clicks, I was able to take an Azure function inside the Logic app to parse a JSON file and extract some information. And now I have a really serverless solution. To see other videos about Logic app, click here on the top. To see another great video about cloud in 5 minutes, just click here on my site. I hope you like it, and I hope this video was useful. See you next time.